Hey there, today is another episode of Gear Wars, and we are talking about bass clarinet stands. Now, bass clarinet stands have evolved quite a bit since I was a kid, and my dad made one out of wood, and it weighed 14 pounds, and it was made out of 2x4. They are now very portable, somewhat lighter than 14 pounds, things that you are going to use all of the time. And it's one of those things like a mattress. You don't really realize how long you've owned it until you kind of look back over the past however many years and realize, geez, this thing is starting to look worn because I've used it every single day for the last 17 years. That's the case with one of my stands. But in the intervening years, I have picked up some new ones that I'd like to show you today. Today we're going to talk about three different stands, bass clarinet stands that I have. One of them is brand new to the market, and I'm really excited to show you. And I'm going to rank them loosely on five different categories. Price, let's see what I have here. Price, how much it costs. Weight, how much does the damn thing weigh? Because those things, some of them can be heavy. Speed of transfer, that means how quickly can I put the bass clarinet in it and get the bass clarinet out of it? This is important when you have one measure to change instruments in, some orchestra piece, for example. Bulkiness, this is how big of a pain in the butt is it to carry along with you? And weight is a factor of that, but also just how it folds up is a factor of that. And speaking of folding up, the fifth one is to talk about, I'm going to talk about how long it takes to set up and tear down this stand, okay, and the process, how many parts does it have, things like that, okay? So here we go. First up is the K&D stand. Now this stand, again, can be had at Amazon for about $165. Weighs 4.5 pounds, or about 2 kilos. It's very easy to take apart and put together, as I will show you right now. You loosen two screws, one, pull the legs down, tighten it. Two, pull the top of the stand up, tighten it. You're done. Now the bass clarinet fits into it two different ways. I put the bell inside the cup, like so, and I rest the top of the bass clarinet joint where there are no keys against the top of the cup of here. This, I don't know what you call it, the neck cup, the collar? I call it the collar. Now I like it this way because the mouthpiece is pointing toward me. So when I want to say, oh, you're not done playing clarinet, finish, put it down, boom. Done. Put it away. Finished. Some other people who don't want to scratch the bell, fine, totally respect that. You can put the peg in the cup and then rest it in the opposite direction in the collar. Now what this does is, it basically does the same thing. It keeps the bell from being scratched. The neck of the bass clarinet and the mouthpiece point away from you. So again, what is the difference? Maybe a half a second, but still, it's just not my preference. So there you have it. Not especially light, very fast to put together, a little bit on the bulky side. You can put your bass clarinet in and take it out really, really quickly. So all in all, not a bad stand for $165. Plus, it's never going to tip over. Well, almost never. Next up is the K&D stand. And this stand is about $80 on Amazon today. It is about 4.5 pounds. It's almost exactly the same weight as the K&D stand, this Hercules stand is. It has more folding parts, so it takes a little bit longer to set up. But here we go. Done. So not too much, too much trouble if you practice. Again, it holds the bass clarinet very much the same way as the K&D stand. So to put your bass clarinet in the Hercules stand, it's again one of two ways. You can put the bell in the rubber cup at the bottom and just let the bass clarinet rest. This one has a weird tendency to let the bass clarinet sort of flip around a little bit, and it's even more pronounced when you put the peg in the cup and put the bass clarinet with the mouthpiece facing backwards. Because at that point, it's just very easy for it to sort of slide around. Now, I don't think it's going to fall off, but it is a little bit disconcerting to have your bass clarinet wobble like that. Speaking of wobbling, it is a very, very sturdy stand. In some ways, it's more sturdy than the K&D is. So that's that. To fold up and pack up the Hercules stand, again, because there are more parts, takes a little bit longer. Push these two buttons on the legs here, fold those guys up, and you're done. So there it is. Again, this has a couple of cool features where you can put pegs for B-flat clarinet or an E-flat clarinet or an A clarinet right on the stand itself, and those pegs will stay on the stand as you fold it. So that's added convenience, right? Obviously, it adds to the weight, but it also adds to the functionality of the stand. So this is the Hercules stand. Last up is the carbon fiber bass clarinet stand made by Woodwind Designs in Holland. Now, the amazing engineering feat of this is that it weighs about a quarter of what the other ones weigh. It weighs about a pound and a quarter or half a kilo. So it's ridiculously light. So that also allows me, with its engineering, to put it inside the bass clarinet case, because this actually fits inside the bore of the bottom joint of the bass clarinet, if you can believe it. And the rest of it just kind of packs around in the bass clarinet case. I don't have to carry an extra stand around with me in addition to my bass clarinet stand. Now, because it is in parts, it takes a little bit longer to put together, but I'll show you how that works. Now, I don't know the names of these. I'm going to call this the block thing, and I'm going to call these the legs. So you slide the first leg into the block, and then the other legs just come right out, and they fit into these the graduated-sized holes in the block itself. It makes cool noises. And you're done. Now, that is the base. The collar fits up on the top, just like so, and the cup is a little magnet, really strong magnet, and it fits in the base of the leg, just like so, and you're finished. Now the thing is, you're gonna notice this is a lot shorter. It's a lot shorter. They do come with an extension, so you can buy an extra extension that takes the collar from here to here, but for me, it doesn't really make enough of a difference for me to use it, and I can still hold a low C bass clarinet on this short stand itself. The catch is, I have to put it in backwards from what I'm used to. Normally, I want to actually have the mouthpiece facing me, but when I do that, it actually will press on the keys itself. Now, I don't want to do that. Why don't I want to do that? Because if the stand presses on the keys are going to start to bend and go out of adjustment. When they go out of adjustment, I have to send it to a repairman. When it's with a repairman, it's out of commission and I can't play it. So, and plus it costs money. So, I'm just going to have to get used to putting it in the stand with the mouthpiece facing backwards. It's remarkably sturdy. Now, obviously, you can kick anything over, but for its weight, it's just incredibly sturdy. Taking it apart is, oh, by the way, easy, you know, if I want to go from holding the bass clarinet, I'm playing clarinet, to the bass clarinet, I play, I put it down, just as fast as all the rest. So really, that's not even a comparison. Taking it apart, because it has more pieces, takes a little bit longer. But not much. Can you tell I've been practicing? Everything fits in this top tube like so, and you're finished. That's it. And like I said, this tube will fit in the bass clarinet bore, right inside the bass clarinet, safely. It won't scratch it. It's very, very smooth. And the rest of it just sort of packs in. So those are the three stands that I have for you today. There was the K&D stand and the Hercules, both of which you can get at Amazon, and this carbon fiber bass clarinet stand from woodwinddesigns.nl. So you have a lot of choices these days. So hope this was helpful. Thanks for coming to Gear Wars. We'll see you next time.